Alright, let's see what we can get. Well, I'm gonna just switch Forte to the fire sword now. Flame sword? Yeah, flame sword. Attack goes up by 4. Figured it wouldn't be much use against flame creatures, so. So now we can sell the blue dragon spear for 1700. Sword or sword for 1700. Right. Okay. Now we do the exchange. Wow. Over 14,000 gents. We never had that many. That much. The snake sword is better. Huh. Not much better. Well, with it is 181. We don't have the sword or sorting. Well, okay. His attack is 121, so if he buys the with the sword or sword, attack is 177. 181. So his attack is 181. Okay, it's 6 more attack. I'm gonna never mind on that. If they have a snake sword at another... Yeah, I'll just keep him with this. I don't want to waste money. But if they find a snake sword later on, or even better yet, another sword that's even better than snake sword, then we'll go for that. So she already has the pierce spear. Well, we found it, so we didn't have to buy it. That was great. Fred can have the snake sword. Alright, we have all these. Large shield, sword or armor. Okay, so the chain shroud is what we want. Forte, I guess, has one already. So we need one for McBain, one for Una, and one for Ada, one for Fred. We need 4 of them, yeah. Wow, we're broke. Okay, Fred with the snake sword. Attack goes up by 10. And McBain with the chain shroud. Defense up by 7. Oh, some mirage mail. Yeah. So, unfortunately with this, her avoidance goes down by 10, but her defense goes up by 33. So, gotta be better to have 33 more defense than 10 more avoidance, right? I think. And Ada. Attack going up by 7. And Fred attack up by 7. Okay. We are decked out. Let's sell this stuff. It only goes for 400 gents, this Mirage Mail. She's had it forever. Three Sworder Armors. Sworder Sword. Silly names for things. Okay. And we're kind of back where we started with 5,000 something gents. As far as money, anyway. It would be fun to go on a tour. You get to go to many places, right? Maybe I should try it. You're gonna tour around and do what? You have to go already? Too bad. I really wanted to dance to my heart's content with your music. Come and perform again. I decided to go shopping at the bazaar sometime soon. I'm excited about that. Alright, don't get killed by monsters. Your performance made me want to play again. Maybe I should take out my sitar and practice. Since the bazaar is open, Ostern has developed a great deal. It may be time for us, the Shinoon tribe, to change too. Maybe. By the way, the bandits... I missed that. By the way, the bandits who attacked the village recently were heavily armored. We thought they were bandits, but when I think of it now, they must have been the numerous army. Just checking, no one in here, right? We'll rest to get, some magic points back. For McBain and Jan and Rick and Una. You hardly ever rest at these things. Farewell, good luck with your travels. How dare you wish me good luck? I'll kill you and everything you stand for. Talk to them. Now I know there are other great entertainers like you... Wait. Now I know that there are great entertainers like you are in other countries. You maybe want to learn more about the other world. It's incredibly awkward to read that. I'd rather practice martial arts than dancing. Well, you could put on a tour and teach people martial arts and display your martial arts and... A little scene and stuff like that. Take on people. You can go on tour and do that.
The descendants of the Water Tribe are still living everywhere in this world. Some form an alliance with each other, and some don't have any communication with others. We can't really stereotype all the descendants of the Water Tribe.
Why not? What if I want to stereotype them? Yeah, we don't need anything from him, I don't think. No. Alright. Yeah, I talked to her. Guess we're done. We can only leave in the way we came from. So I guess we're heading back to Oasis. Who wants to fight me now? Ada says, "Listen, Una, do you think I've lost some weight?" "What are you talking about?" asks Fred. Una says, "You know, I was hoping to slim down because I've been breaking a sweat a lot. Want to lose weight, so says Fred. Come on. Kids should be kids. I'm not a kid, says Ada. I'm 15, believe it or not. You will never understand the mentality of women. Mentality of women, says Forte. Did you say anything, says Ada. No, nothing. Una, Ada, you guys should stay as you are, says McBain. What do you mean by that, asks Una. What I mean is that you're pretty as you are. Ha ha ha, do you mean it, says Ada. Really, says Una. There you go, Mr. McBain. What's with Fred's murmurings? Not Fred's murmur. Yeah, Fred's murmurings. He keeps mumbling about stuff and wonder when it'll be revealed what the hell he's on about. Should we talk to these people again? I was able to lay in all the items I wanted. I'll be on to a big winner with them. All the hard work of walking all around the bazaar paid off. I found a rare discovery. To the success of my discovery, cheers! The trader poured down coconut beer. Oh yeah! I live for this moment, for this one glass. I'm feeling hotter because I had a drink. Because it's alcohol. Okay, I'll talk to him last. Fred, the boss is already back, says Uni. Good. What a timing, says Fred. There's nothing out of the ordinary at the bar. I guess Fred's gonna be leaving us now. We didn't even use him in any battles. Go look around. You may not have much appetite because of this heat, but still you better eat something. If you're hungry, you'll run out of gas quickly. He said that before. They don't say anything new. The bazaar is seeing great success, so the people in Selbart should come here for shopping. That's nice. Tell them that. I think some of them are coming, though. So if we try to go out this way, it stops us, right? Oh. That's me. He just sells things. He doesn't talk. Fortune teller. No. Item shop. Look, I just had Furio shine my shoes. They're really shiny, aren't they? Yep. And soon you'll just have sand all over them. Did you find anything rare in Selbart? I will take in if you wish to. What? I will take in? What the hell does that mean? Fred is out now? I want to have a drink with him, though. Well, I think he's going back to the bar now. Yeah. Go visit his old house again. See if he says anything this time. Nope. Okay. See, they have the water, but they don't have the caves. So each town has its own little intricacies, I guess. The boss says, Fred, you're back. Boss, you're back. I'm sorry I've been out for a long time. I'm sure you had a good reason. Anyway, I have big news. The Numerous army has withdrawn from Marcheros. Commander Xenon was stationed in Cavaro, but I heard that he was driven away by the citizens and resistance movement. Hee-haw! They did it, says Ada. The mayor and citizens did a great job, says Una. And who are these people? The boss says. They are members of a troubadour company, says Fred. They are here to ask you a favor. We are the McBain Company, says McBain. Thank you for taking the time to meet us. Nice meeting you. My name is Garten. Garten? McBain? No way! Mac! You're Mac the hack musician. You're Garten the crooked dealer. You changed a great deal. Did you guys know each other? Says Fred. Duh. We hung out a lot when we were children, says Garten. McBain says, we used to see each other when I was on the tour once in a while. You've gained a lot of presence since I saw you last. It's been over 10 years since our last meeting, says Garten. McBain says, you've done a great job turning this desert road into a prosperous bazaar. Ha ha ha. This place has treated me pretty nice and made me some dough. And are these young lads your grandchildren? Only this one is my grandson. I'm Forte. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too, says Garten. You look a lot like Mac when he was small. Really? Oh yeah, like twins. I don't know if it's a good thing, says Forte. Did you say something? Asked McBain. Uh-oh. I can't believe we've aged enough to have grandchildren, Garten says. Anyway, what was the favor that you wanted to ask me? Yeah. I heard a rumor that you possess a very rare stone. So I came here to check it out, because it might be something I'm looking for. Oh, that. Hold on, I think I put it in my inside pocket. Well, oh, here it is. Garten took out a paperweight made from rills. I keep calling the roses. What do you think of it? Pretty rare, huh? It's made from those rills that the monsters drop. Everybody's like stunned. What's wrong? Forte says, it's palm size and the letters are carved. It looks similar, but it's a little bit different. So this is not what you're looking for, huh? Sorry for getting you excited for nothing. Don't mention it, says McBain. Sorry about bothering you for nothing. Tell me about what you're looking for. It's called a resonance stone. It's a pebble that a composer named Leon is supposed to have carved his music on. Oh, it's Leon's memorabilia. Isn't he a tragic musician who was captured around here by some aristocrat spy? Captured? Says Forte. He was captured around here, says Una. There's a rumor that an aristocrat from some country kidnapped him and incarcerated him to make him compose new music. So the rumor was originated from here, says McBain. You didn't know? It was when you still lived here. It occurred 50 years ago, says McBain. Captured by an aristocrat spy. Grandpa? Grandpa Mac, don't take it so hard. I feel like I've forgotten something very important. Boys, I gotta go somewhere now. You're leaving? Forte says, where to? To my first home. Do you remember a decayed house standing near here? Did you used to live there? Asked Forte. That's right. Okay, he's still with us. I thought he was leaving the group. Mac, your home is still standing behind the bar. It crossed my mind to tear it down, but I felt bad for you. I owe you one, says McBain. It's not behind the bar, it's to the east. I didn't touch anything there, but I haven't cleaned the house either. There must be a mess inside. If you want to go back to live there, I'll fix it for you. So you lived in that house, the old one behind here. It was 50 years ago, McBain says again. Wow, okay. Just checking really quick to see if there are new things, and we'll go check out the house. Hi, Fred. I haven't seen you at the bar lately. I'm sorry. I had to go to Cell Bar to take care of many things, but come visit us at the bar again. I'll treat you to a glass of lemonade. Hey, you're putting in a plug for the bar. Fred, the boss will fire you if you keep skipping your job like that. The boss is well aware. As soon as I make money enough to buy her a hair accessory, I'll quit being a shoe shiner and go back to Enid. He said something like that before. Maybe exactly that. We'll take in. I don't think you can see fabrics well from there. Come around the counter and take a closer look at it. It's been a while since we had that dialogue of, you know, don't talk to me from this side of the counter thing. Let's see if anyone else says it. Since you're here, please take a look around my proud items. Come around the front. Who knows, you may be able to find rare stuff. This guy say anything? I'm chicken-hearted. I can't say anything strongly, but can you come around the counter if you want to buy something? Chicken-hearted. Are you interested in finding out about your destiny? If you wish me to enlighten you, please take a seat. There's nowhere to sit. How do I get in here? We do business on the table. That's basic. If you want to buy something, come around the counter. That's funny. Like, for the most part, they make it so that you can't go around. You have to go near the counter. I'm trying to talk to her, but the tree's getting in the way. The area is covered with sand, and the weather is very dry, but the fresh and juicy fruits you can eat are better than anything else. I think it's 100 times more tasteful to eat fruits here than where the weather is good. I'm so happy to be born here. Okay, let's go visit that house. That's not where it is. Wait till we go into this slow walk. So this is the house you used to live in when you were a child, Grandpa? Slow walk. McBain says, no one has lived here for over 50 years. It's unbelievable to see that this house is still standing. Yeah, but there's no roof. This is the bed I used when I was a child. Why didn't I realize it till now? If I didn't see Garten, all of this might have been buried deep inside my memories. Oh, so he was trying to remember. That's why it was so quiet and didn't say anything. Forte, have I told you why I decided to become a musician? I think I asked you right after we started the tour. You told me it was when you had an opportunity to talk to some performer. Una says, but you also said you don't remember who that was or what you guys talked about. Yeah, it was an event 50 years ago. The moon was beautiful that night. Ooh, flashback time. Oh, it's Tiny McBain. Going, hmm? A whistle? Horses? Oh no. Oh yeah. I'm like, no, it's people. Oh no, it's horses too. That's a funky looking wagon there. About to say, I'm gonna fall in the water. Soldier says, hey, let's take a break. Do you want anything? Young man doesn't answer. Just leave him alone. It's an order not to pay attention to him. But I like the tune. I feel like my heart is purifying, as may be expected of a great musician. Don't try to be a hero. Whistle as long as you want. Why don't you come out? Says the young man. Boy says, wow, how'd you know I was there? I have pretty good ears, says the young man. I regard myself as a musician, even though I may not look like one. The boy says, you don't look like a bad person, but why are you incarcerated? Ha ha ha, I don't know why either. Some higher-up person wants me to write music for him. This is Leon, and that's McBain in the bed. Do you live around here? Yeah, I heard you whistle. Do you want me to get you out of the cage? Thanks, but it's okay. To tell you the truth, I've wanted to meet that higher-up person. I don't like the way they treat me, but it provided me a good answer. Really? I'm not going to help you then. Thank you for caring about me. You said you're a musician, right? Did you also compose that tune you were whistling? Yeah. Are you interested in music? Not until now. Oh, so this is McBain also. I thought it was some other kid. When I was listening to your whistling, that made me want to whistle like you did. I see. Everything starts from that kind of desire. If you cherish your desire, you'll be able to become the number one musician in the world. I don't think I have that much talent. The talent people possess by nature plays a small part. We all have unlimited potential. If you don't forget about the passion you felt at first, probably anyone could fulfill his own dream. Music, huh? That sounds good. I made up my mind. I'll try my best to be the number one musician in the world. Good for you. Hang in there. Ha ha ha. I better thank that higher-up person. Thanks to their harsh welcome, I was able to send the future great musician into the world. You're making a drama out of nothing. But are you sure you don't need any help? Yeah, I'm okay, but I have a favor to ask you. Can you keep this for me? What is it? I would say a piece of potential. Potential? Potential doesn't always mean a good thing. It has dangerous potential to invite destruction. So I can't let that higher-up person to have it. Then why don't you throw it away? It's dangerous, but there might be someone coming forth who needs it. I don't want to eliminate the hope. All right, I'll keep it for you. Hmm. I guess they're back, says the young man. I'll talk to you later. Okay. Hang in there. Kick the higher-up person's butt. Gotcha. Well, let's get going, says the soldier. We can't make His Majesty wait too long, or we'll be sent to exile. Pretty harsh. You're late. Exile the both of you. What's going on with him? Oh, he's straining to lift that? Oh, he hid it under the floorboards. This should be good enough. So now we can dig up the floorboards. Grandpa, you mean that was... thought he was going to use Rock Crash. McBain took out a resonance stone from under the floor. Forte and his friends obtained the resonance stone of darkness. McBain dusts off the resonance stone. That's what I thought. I don't know why I've totally forgot about this. Grandpa. Fred says, the resonance stone may have reacted to Mr. McBain's memory, since it's called the darkness. So it was a natural thing that I had been attracted to Leon's music. It's because Leon's whistling was my starting point as a musician. Forte says, earth, water, fire, wind, light, and darkness. Now we obtain all the ferocious resonance stones, we're ready to solve the trick set in the limestone cave. Leon may be the one who guided us, says McBain. Let's hurry back to the Grim Bridge, says Ada. Yeah. At any rate, says Forte, who in the world was the higher-up person who captured Leon? We'll find that out in the future, says McBain. How do you know? Anyway, let's head to the limestone cave at the Grim Bridge. Wow. Alright. I guess we're not heading on to Enid. We're gonna go back to the Grim Bridge. Before we do that, we'll talk to all these people again. Nothing new so far. We didn't try behind the counter with him, did we? Yeah, it doesn't say anything different. Fred, what are you going to do about a bartender job here? I've decided to help them out. I'll drop by sometime again. Fred is unpredictable and suddenly goes missing, so we really can't rely on him as far as the job is concerned. Weren't you talking to Fred? What are you going to do now, Mac? I'm going back to the Grim Bridge. I have some business to take care of. Hey, boss. Says Fred. I decided to keep them company. Catch you later. Please give Mac a hand. I appreciate it. Forte says, that's weird to see him being so polite. Yeah, usually the boss is on top, says Ada. Ahem. Fred, please give Mac a hand. Roger dat. Roger dat. Yep, Fred going missing. Bye. I really thought he was going to leave us. And go back to tending the bar. Alright, so back to the Grim Bridge next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. And always, seek adventure.